Before Nest, you really didn't care about what a thermostat was. You didn't shop for one. You didn't understand what the feature sets were. Your thermostat matters to help reduce your energy bills, but also to help with global climate change. People are worrying about solar panels and all these very expensive things when you can do simple things inside your home with a thermostat. Nest, we believe, is trying to educate the consumer about their energy habits.
The world really as a whole are using more and more energy, and a lot of that goes into buildings, really. It always comes out your wall in the same way, whether it's made by burning coal, whether it's made by burning natural gas, whether it's produced at a nuclear power plant, or whether it's produced by a wind plant. We sometimes forget, I think, that all that electricity we use, those, you know, billions and billions of gigawatts, has to come from somewhere. Whatever energy is used to either heat your home or cool it, you know, that is where most of the energy you'll be using for your home comes from, or, you know, is used actually.
And that's when I understood it's not just about solar panels, it's not just about geothermal energy. It's also about the energy consumption of a heating and cooling system in a home and how you control that consumption. So this is the Nest Learning Thermostat here. When you looked at the thermostat and it hadn't changed for 30 years, you were like, wait a second, this is ripe for innovation, it's ripe for disruption, let's go fix that problem.
If you look at early thermostats, actually, the most ancient buildings all had thermostats. The buildings were thermostats. People have always worried about the temperature of the place around them and have adapted buildings to that purpose.
Back in the 40s and 50s was truly the revolution of the home.
Right now is a wonderful time to buy a GE 2-in-1 refrigerator food freezer like this one.
That's when we really put in electrical appliances. In the home, we got washers, dryers, cooling in the home.
What a nuisance it is to have to scrape the frost off the freeze chest.
Especially the thermostat from that era.
They're the sort of brown little plastic bricks. It's amazing to me how badly designed some of these can be. In a hotel where you go in and you have to flip a thing that says cool or heat, really?
And today, now we're going through a new revolution with internet-connected appliances and products that have been unloved since they really were invented in the 40s and 50s.
Tony Fadell is famously associated with the creation of the iPod.
What is iPod? iPod is an MP3 music player.
What was very clear in the design was the iPod was all about music consumption. That's all it was about, and the complexity was all left inside of the application that was on your portable computer. Well, if we look at something like Nest, we kept the Nest itself very, very simple. You just turn it up and down.
It's not the only smart thermostat out there. There's actually many, you know, but what's unique about this is really its design.
We could have just made a rectangular plastic box, but we believe that the more you're attracted to it, the more you might want to learn from it and use it properly. I think it starts with education first. 50 to 60% of a home's energy consumption is controlled by a thermostat. So if they need heat, they should be good about it. They should learn about it. So we can go in and we can look at the schedule. You can see each day what it's doing, and you can go through the week.
This device is anticipating, it's learning, it's collating information. It's actually personalizing. The other thing is, while you could look at it as just an efficiency unit, in other words, it's helping you be less bad, and that it may not actually be changing our behaviors, but it leads us to the idea that we could have things that are more good.
You know, there's a risk always whenever you buy something with the feeling that you want to become greener, that that can sort of become a substitute for actually doing anything more than that. But in reality, I think once you begin to sort of go down this road, you may start to see, well, I can improve the house, I can make the house more energy efficient.
Clearly, this will lead to houses that are renewably powered, cost effectively, because it'll all become transparent to everybody. You'll become mindful of these things. And that's why I think it's such an important part of the story. So I see this as just the harbinger of great things to come.
We're almost at 2 billion kilowatt hours saved. That is enough energy to power the US for 30 minutes. What could it be when we're in 10% of homes or 20% of homes, and we're only at the beginning of climbing this mountain? Where could we be in 5 years? I can't predict, but I'm hopeful it's going to be even more accelerated than it is today.